Welcome back, everyone. We are going to be taking a look at a biggin. This channel started with just unboxings, going through my stashes and new purchases and showing off all the sprues. And people loved it. And then they said, why don't you build some kits? So it's kind of transitioned into mostly a vast majority of builds, 104 builds a year, two every single week. But let's get back to just doing some unboxings of kits that I have that have been sent to the show that I'm simply not going to have time to do. I can't build 42 kits every month, but we can show stuff off and let you look at it. We're going to do an unboxing of Revell's in the Revell Germany boxing, the 1/25th scale Peterbilt 359. This big honking truck has opening doors. It's got a removable top so you can look inside the sleeper, a tilt forward hood design. It's got hoses, chains, lines. It is just under 13 inches long. You can steer the front wheels. This kit's got a lot of stuff in it, so let's take a look. We're gonna do this unboxing a little different than we've done before. I'm gonna show off a couple trees, then we're gonna stop for a second and do a still photo of those trees, and then we'll move on to the next set of trees. The first two up are this one with an absolute massive amount of hoses and lines involved. We got the mount for the fifth wheel right there. You can see that it's completely adjustable, textured, ribbed. We got the nice air and exhaust lines. Clean molding on here. I'm not noticing any flashing just from unboxing the trees. Got our fifth wheel, got our drive shafts. Nice dashboard. You can see that the detail on the dashboard on this section is completely smooth. And we've got the gauges that are raised up to go in there, and the switches, and all the other accoutrements with the wood grain dash. There's even detail on that. Nice steering wheel. Oh, I spotted some flash. Whole kit's ruined. All right. Well, I'll just have to recycle it when I'm done. Spotted some flash. It's all over now. Excellent detail on there. I like these little Peterbilt mud flaps, lower fender guards, whatever they'd be. Awesome. Got part of our air brake assemblies, lines, tanks, two pieces. Go to the next tree in this series. We've got the frame rails, and that's pretty cool. They've got the linkages and stuff molded in, so you know your mold, you know your mounting stuff and the airbags. You know you're mounting your axles in the right position, front and rear. The other frame rails coming down. Large location marks. We'll flip this over as well. Cross members on the frame. Flash! Oh! Like a little tiny piece there, like a little potato chip. You take that off, you chew on it. Don't swallow it. It's good for you, though. More of our springs. Got our front axle there with our steering. Got linkages, rear springs, shackles. We got our differentials coming up. We got more parts of our frame in here. Like I said, those differentials all looks nice and sharp, and all the different mounts for the airbags and the other halves of the airbags. Very nice looking tree there. So we will be back. I'll get out the other two trees. I'll be back in just a second. Next up, we'll bring out the engine tree. Nice halves on that. Ooh, all the pumps and lines. Ooh, cylinder head on there. Nice looking. We got our intake and exhaust manifolds. Got parts of our transmission. I like the bolt detail on there. You can kind of dirty that up a little bit. Dust it up, even if you're doing a really fresh truck. Still going to have some road dust in there. We got parts of our sleeper cab. Got the visor for the cab right there. Got our two doors. Door handles molded in. Looks like we got some nice large mounts for our mirrors and stuff. That's always nice to have pre-done for you. I hear this kit can be quite intensive to build. That's why it's a level 5. I do not recommend it for first-time model builders. Nice interior door panels. seat backs are right there, and even those have texture. Got our fenders. Nice, smooth plastic. We'll take paint. Very nice. And I know you guys like them molded in white, so you can paint it your chosen color. Go to the back side. You can see the under fenders. Some more texture on that sleeper. That'll be the inside of the sleeper there. Little ejection pin mark on the inside, the bottom of the visor, but that's not going to matter. Snip that off. No one will ever see it again unless you're sitting in the cab. And none of you watching are 2 inches tall, so that's impossible. Second tree in this one, the interior of the sleeper. They didn't miss a beat with that. They've even got it tucked and tufted on the roof, on all the walls inside, even the entryway. We'll flip this tree over in just a second. Got it on the back wall. Check it out. It's even got the interior door panel, since you can see inside. That's really slick. We got some more mounts there. We'll flip it over. We got our cab roof right there. We got the interior of the cab with textured, rubberized, high grip. We got the seat suspension. We got our firewall with lines you can detail. We got the exterior of the sleeper. Nice panel lines on all that. We've got our nice bed. That looks really comfortable. So if you are 2 inches, you got something to sleep on. And we've got more electronics for inside the back. And that's it for those trees. That's the big cab and sleeper tree. I'll be back with the next one. The next two trees, the chrome tree. Look at all that chrome on there. Wow. Kind of get a glimpse of me in there. Hello. We got steps. Look at that nice bumper. Look, there's my eyeball. You can see me back there. Battery boxes, smokestacks, blackwash in there. That'll look really tough. Got our rear bumper. The lights are molded in. Use some Tamiya clears or Sharpie markers in whites and reds. And whatever you want to use back there, you'll be all set. Got our nice wheels. Got what looks like some mud flaps. Windshield wipers. Air horns. Mirror pieces. There's the other parts of the mirror. Check out that grill. Heavy, heavy blackwash. Or insert into each panel a black screen material, or cover the whole thing with a road screen. A little metal mesh screen. My dad, when he drove truck, used to put them behind the grill. Every single vehicle, personal and everything, he put window screen behind it. Keeps all the stuff from hitting the radiator. The man drove all those years over the road and dump trucks in town and regular vehicles and never blew a radiator. So it must have done something good. The second tree is a lot of diamond plate for the rack, the protection behind the sleeper. All that diamond plate. We got the gorgeous wheels. We got our side steps. We got the tanks and halves. We got mirrors. Really reflective. Look at that. Holy cow. I like the larger pieces for the mirrors with this part molded in, this down arm. That makes putting the mirrors on with those molded in sections that we saw on the sides of the doors. Makes those mirrors so much easier to get on than older kits. Oh, got some little spoke wheels. What are those about? All right, geniuses that know what this is, was there a bicycle included with this kit or a motorcycle? Tell me what those are in the comments. I don't know why those would be in there. I haven't looked through the assembly manual to find out why. Got the other tank there. And that is it for the second chrome tree. I'll stage the next stuff. We'll be right back. Next up is the cab. You can see the cab and the hood are molded together. You would, of course, cut that unless you want to have a really long nose and some supreme ventilation. We got the opening for the sleeper around the back. We got the doors. The doors don't have to open if you don't want. You can glue them shut. However you want to build your model kit. That's what I always say. You don't think you can build those doors to open or get them to line up right? Just go ahead and glue them shut. No one's going to care. Got that nice hood. Peterbilt logo, so you know right where to put the decal. Got the nice split windshield. Got our marker light up top. Underneath, even the inside of the interior is tufted. Very nice. All right, we will take a look before we shut down on this one. We got the manual here, and it's a book. I mean, it's a big manual. They give you some nice history of Peterbilt and the 359. It is a very nice manual. They let you know everything that's going to be in the kit, a big parts breakdown. They got, of course, a full paint guide inside, as they should. And the direction manual is really, really crisp. Look at how crisp those drawings are. Shouldn't be any confusion on how to assemble that. And I think with a manual that good, most folks should be able to get this together. Not a first timer, but even then, I think maybe, you know, an adult or older teen, you know, 14, 15 could probably do this. If you're younger and you can do it, good for you. Excellent looking manual. Really, really nice detail. Gives you a full paint and decal guide on the back. Isn't that a sexy machine? It's got that nice movable air dam. Tells you how to detail the back, the headache rack, and everything back there. Nice. Nice looking. So what else is in the box? We're going to find out in just a second. The last things in the box are our multimedia parts. We've got yellow wire, we've got black wire for hoses and lines, and I like that it's an actual, like a wire. The black is a hose, it's an open-ended hose. The yellow is a wire, which means if you coil it, it should hold its shape. And then some really nice chain. And that looks like trucker chain with the rounded ends. That's really nice, I'm glad they sourced that. Where they did the kit, we've got our clear parts, windshield, bug shield. It's even got a bug shield. You know, I didn't even notice that on the box. It does have a bug shield. That's cool. That's very, very vintage. Bug shield's big thing on those trucks. Dad even had them on his smaller trucks, his private, you know, the pickups and the SUVs that he owned. Got our headlights in there, the squared off headlights. Fog lights and everything on our nice clear tree and crystal clear. No distortion through and not even on the bug shield. Excellent looking. We've got a set of 10 rubber. They're very sticky. They smell. Can you smell it? Smell like rubber. They are Michelin X series. They are printed all the way around. They've got a very narrow tread pattern on them. You'll get 10 of them. I don't see, there's no wider one, so it's not like there's any front steer tires in here that I can see. I mean, we can check really quick, but I didn't see any, no, they're all the same size, so it doesn't matter. This is what you got all the way around. They're very flexible, so you could easily assemble your wheels and then squeeze these over them if you want to do a special paint on your wheels and not two-part them. Nice name brand on both sides. So those are going to look pretty tough on there. And finally, in the kit, a really, really nice set of decals. Now, I haven't had any problem with modern Revell decals. They come out very well. We've got metallic gold. They're actually shining. We've got chrome details on the dash decals. So if you want to use these, you could either sand the detail off or just put these on before you even, without even putting on those things, or use a heavy coat of decal solvent, and I bet these will suck right down all around that raised detail and really give it a nice 3D effect. But I like that metallic shine around the gauges. We got all kinds of instrumentation. The Peterbilt logos are even metallic. That's why I'm moving them like that, so you can see. We got our reflectors, and even those are silver for our side lights. We've got the silver trim around the blue lines is even on there. Just lovely. And then the rest of your decals, we got Texas and Montana plates. The blue is really, I mean, you got a lot of the blue, and the gold is really tough too. Classic 359 in a silver and a red. Very, very nice, Revell. Nice job on those decals. And that is it. That is everything that's in the box for the Big Honkin' 359. 302 parts, 1/25th scale for you, those of you that love the 1/25th scale. This is in it. Even though it's a Revell Germany boxing, it is originally a Revell USA kit, so it will be in the 1/25th scale. I thank you all for watching the workshop. Enjoy the bonus unboxings I'll be doing more often, and we'll see all of you at the next review.